We're not going to bore you with round after round after round of agility. You're going to see two or three agility rounds, and you're going to see lots of basic training, tricks, and fun things, which I hope you're going to enjoy. It's a wonderful breed, as I've said. It's very sturdy, very hardy, and the whole team is going to be here all day. If you want to chat to them, you see them walking about, please do. Come and ask about the dogs if you want to learn. Come and meet the dogs. You'll see just how lovely and friendly they are. You'll see a variety of colours in the ring, and you'll often see blue advertised as being an extremely rare colour. It is, in fact, over 70% of all staff is registered, so it isn't rare at all. It's just one of the standard colours. We also have them in brindle, black brindle, red brindle, and pie colours. And you'll see them all with their fantastic handlers who work very hard so that when the dogs come in, they do everything they want to and some of the things the handlers have trained them to do. So very shortly, I'm going to hand over to the lady who helps organise this lot. She is the secretary of the club. She's standing just to my right. And this is Leslie, who is the secretary of the club. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Christina. We're just waiting for our first dog to arrive, and she's just coming into the ring. So the first dog in the ring today is Queenie. And thank you very much. We welcome applause at any time. Queenie is going to show you a demonstration of a new activity that's sweeping the boards that's called hoopers. So you can see the hoops, you can see the barrels, you can see the tunnels. It's a very good distance ball. It's excellent for young and old. It's excellent for able and less able. And that's two-legged and four. And as you can see, you can use distance handling. You can run around up close if you want to. But it's really good and really fast and furious. So we think Queenie's done really well. Now, Queenie, who you saw there, is actually mum to the next dog that's coming in the ring, and the dad to the next dog in the ring you're going to see later. So we're just going to wait for the hooper stuff to come out of the ring to make some space. And then the next dog in is going to be Jersey. Now this is going to be interesting because Jersey is going to fly around our agility ring. So what we're showing you here is that Staffordshire Bull Terriers should be, as per their breed standard, active and agile. I think you're going to agree when we watch this. That's exactly what Jersey is. Now she's a grade 7 dog, for everybody that knows how the agility works. And she's also a really fast and furious dog, and she's mum to some puppies that we're going to see later. So you're going to get a treat with seeing those too. Our breed, as I say, asks for us to be muscular, active and agile. Lots of them like to be couch potatoes too, but not this one, I don't think. There she goes. Great round of applause for that round of agility with Jersey. Marvellous. And now coming into the ring is Izzy. Now, Izzy here is 5, and she's been doing tricks with Jersey almost before she could walk. I think when she was sitting upright, she started her tricks. So she's going to show you some tricks. Now, the reason we're doing this is because, again, we are really proud that Staffordshire Bull Terriers are one of only 2 breeds where the KC breed standard actually calls for the suitability with children. Brilliant little trick, that one, isn't it? Wait till you see her later in the display. She's going to get to do some reversing work. And, of course, she's going to get a treat with the ball at the end for doing it right, because that's really important. Now, of course, although they're meant to be suitable with children, we all know you never leave children and dogs alone together. You're always going to supervise them. But it is true, Staffords and kids are a great bond together. So Jersey's done a bit of work there, and Izzy started her work with us today. They're going to rest on their laurels now. So we have a nice little seat for them. 2 of them are going to sit together. And we now have Jersey's puppies coming into the ring. So here's a treat for you. 4 puppies. Now this was obviously from a very well planned mating. Avril and Joe, who bred the litter, decided on the dog they wanted, went for type and temperament, as you would do, made sure that they complied with all the relevant health testing. We have a couple of specific DNA health tests in our breed that need to be done, and some clinical testing too. And here you'll see, I'll explain who's who. To my left here is Tate, who's circling cones. Up in the top corner there is little Wren, who's going round and round her stall. We have Hattie, who's still living at home with Avril and her mum and everybody else in that family. They're doing some reversing work. And down the bottom here we have Olive, who's come all the way from Wales to do some creeping. And she's very good too. And I'm sure you are going to see a lot more of all of these dogs later. But of course, for today, we just thought it would be really nice to show some early training with a whole litter full of six-month-old puppies. Oh, Jersey's decided she's going to come and join in. That's really great. She says, I'm not just going to have my child take all the plaudits, and I can do it too. So thank you very much to puppies. That's really good to see. Big round of applause for the pups doing their bit. Of course, with puppies, you develop things slowly. But then you can up the ante a little bit and do a little bit more work with them if you want to carry on. So next we're going to show some balance training. And we have some older dogs here. Now on our team, we do have some dogs that are KC registered that were very thoughtfully bred. We also have some rescue dogs. And Odie here, who's going to be in the centre of the ring today, is one of our rescue dogs. So we're going to lay out our balance equipment. Now you've heard of synchronised swimming. We're going to show you some synchronised spinning. So let's have some spinning dogs, please. See if we can get them to all go round at once. That would be a great feat. Round and round and round and round they go. Absolutely. Some of these have only just learnt this trick, so you must bear with us. But they do enjoy a stall and showing off and a bit of balance work. So having done some spinning, we're now going to also do a little bit more training. So we're going to work on the balance again. We're going to swap over the stalls. We're going to give them some other balance equipment to work on. Of course, the balance work will always strengthen their core. Really important if they are going to compete in any canine disciplines, so if they are going to be agility dogs or anything. So, who we have here in the ring at the moment, at the top end there we have Belle, who's balancing on her donut. At the end here nearest to me we have Baz, who's balancing on his peanut. And centrally we have Dodie, our rescue dog, who's going to do a bit of balancing on her balance beam. It's not very wide at all, that balance beam. It's quite difficult to get the dog to walk along it. And especially to balance if we can get her to do a sit and balance at the end. It takes a lot of trust in the owner as well to do these things, so working really hard with them. Getting them to concentrate and also getting them to do stuff here. Magic. Well done. Smashing balance, Dodie. Nice round of applause for that lot. Really working on the body work. And then of course when you've done all that hard work and made sure your dog's muscles are well warmed up, if you're really lucky, you can then compete like our mighty Mouse does. So next in the ring here we have Mouse. He's dad to Jersey, who you saw earlier. Believe it or not, he's 10 years old. And he's pretty fast. So again, he's going to demonstrate the active part of our claws. Now you may have seen Mouse or any of Joe's dogs or indeed some of the others of our dogs. They often take part in any media stuff, so you might have seen them on the TV. I think Mouse has been in EastEnders in the past. They love to perform, obviously, these dogs. And this dog also has been shown and in his time has won 2 reserve CCs. He also has an agility warrant. So he is, in fact, the only Staffordshire Bull Terrier, to our knowledge, in the UK that has a junior warrant and an agility warrant gold. And he is our Java Wolf Mighty Mouse. Marvellous. Big round of applause for Mouse. Thank you very much. Now, next into the ring, we're going to have a couple of the dogs back to show some obedience exercises, because some of them have been working with Good Citizen stuff. But to introduce this today, we're going to bring in Ali Taylor. Now, Ali, you might have noticed, standing in the wings here. She works for Battersea, and I'm going to hand over to her to tell you about this bit.
Well, I'd like to say a big thank you to the display team, because they work tirelessly up and down the country, showing education and showing what staffies can really do. And they are a big, big support as well to rescue. So a big well done, guys. Right, so I'm going to talk about a few of these dogs here in the middle. First up, we have Tracy and Belle, who's in the far corner. And Belle has her Gold Good Citizen. As well as that, what we have got is Tracy is a diabetic. And literally what happens is Belle alerts Tracy when her blood levels are either high or very low. So Belle has actually saved Tracy's life on more than one occasion. So that, to me, deserves a big, massive clap. In the middle, we have Danny and Lewis. And Lewis is 11 years old. And he's a rescue. So well done, Danny. You can see Lewis on the Stafford stand over the weekend. But we also need to give this lad a big, massive cheer, because it's going to be his last performance at Crufts. He's taken a bit of a retirement and he's going to have his feet up. And last, we have the lovely Kelly and Az. Again, a Gold Citizen dog, and will be appearing over the weekend in the main arena and on the Stafford agility display as well. So a big, massive well done to everyone, and thank you for inviting me.
So thank you very much to Ali for filling in for that part. We couldn't really do it without her. Normally we would have had her and Squirt, but unfortunately Squirt, her lovely rescue dog, is ageing a bit, so she's resting on her laurels. Now last year you might remember young Izzy, who you saw earlier, ran Dakota, her own dog. Now I think I'm going to be wasting my time talking to you because you're not going to listen. But literally today, Izzy is going to bring Milo in. Now Milo is a Labrador Stafford cross. It will give us a little chance to talk about a lot of the bull breed crosses that are in rescue. And sometimes for us as a breed, that's a problem, because a lot of the dogs that do get pulled out in media are described as the generic Staffy, when in fact a lot of them are crossbred. But say, this is where I'm going to be wasting my time talking, because you will not listen, because Izzy is going to take this dog all the way round the ring on her own. So I think I'll just sit and let you do it, watch. Obviously it's a little bit much for Milo, because this is a big ring. There's just been a whole load of dogs in and sniffing. But I have to tell you, as a very proud team leader, that last weekend Izzy and Milo actually competed in agility, and believe it or not, got three clear rounds. That is phenomenal. Izzy's 5 years old. What do you think? Is she a handler of the future? Nearly finished, Milo. Oh, he was doing ever so well. He needs to listen to you, Izzy, doesn't he? Let him just finish his little piece. I need to get out of the way before I'm Milo'd. She said, okay, Milo, it's time to go. Fabulous. Bring the house down for Izzy and Milo. That was fantastic. So to finish up today, we're going to give you a little bit more comedy, because Staffordshire Bull Terriers do like to bring some comedy into your life. If ever you've lived with one, you'll know exactly what I mean. Now, in the past, you may have seen Blake being our magical act. Well, he's decided he'd like to do an escapology act for you today. So I think today we may well rename him Houndini, if you'll excuse the pun. Now, this is his girlfriend, Nala, and we've popped her away in her crate. She's going to be padlocked in very securely. He's watching and wagging his tail. No way out. Combination padlock there as well. Make it as difficult as possible. So now we're going to do the same with Blake. Oh, sorry, Houndini. Your girl is crying. Lock that door. Padlock securely, Darren. Spin those dials. Securely locked. Cover with the fabulous golden cloth. And now we need to see if he really can escape. So what do we reckon? How long do we think? One, two, three. Escape dog. But that's obviously only half the trick. Can he release the girl? How are we going to do this one? Pressure's on. Well done. Hooray, he's saved the girl. So let's see. Can Blake take a bow? We maybe get two of them having a bow. Oh, he's going to go off for a wander now. Take a bow, Blake. And we just need one follow-up for him.
I can. My dog is, so can yours. Yeah, it's not. It's a chihuahua. Size shouldn't matter. Can your dog do this? No, it won't happen. A one, a two, a three. Yeah.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that's ending the demonstration for today. So I'd just like to ask you for a round of applause for the wonderful display team from the East Anglian Staffordshire Bull Terrier Club. Thank you for coming. We hope to see you again next year. As I've said, if you want to talk to any of these people, please come back and see us later on. Thank you, gang. Thank you. You've been a good crowd.
Come on, folks, put your hands together. It's the East Anglian Staffordshire Bull Terrier display team. What a great display, as usual, just for us here at Croft.